Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Kembali lagi di channel saya, back to my channel, Bapak Hakim, di mana channel ini mendiskusikan tentang teknologi, edukasi, dan juga sedikit tentang musik ya. Nah, in this occasions, I would like to tell you all or explain to you all about seven phrases that we can use in our daily life, atau bahasa frasa keren yang bisa kita pakai dalam keseharian kita, yang tentunya belum banyak kita gunakan di dalam keseharian kita. Makanya kita bakal diskusikannya di sini, 7 kelanjutan daripada frasa keren yang saya tuturkan di video sebelumnya. Nah, ini sekarang 7 lanjutan daripada frasa kerennya. Oke. Jadi kita mulai dari yang ke-8 ya. Ya, oke. Yang ke-8 ini bisa dibilang perasanya sangat jarang kita dengar ya. Yaitu on pins and needles. On pins and needles, ya. On pins and needle. Something that we haven't known before, ya. Oke. What about the meaning? The meaning is anxious, nervous instead of suspense. Oke, artinya kita ini cemas, gelisah, nervous, atau dalam situasi yang tegang. Nah, on pins and needles. Jadi kita bisa mengekspresikan situasi ketika kita cemas, nervous, dan juga kita tegang menggunakan on pins and needles. What about the example? I was on pins and needles the whole day when the result of the national examination had to be announced. I was on pins and needles the whole day when the result of the national examination had to be announced. Nah, jadi gugup di situ katanya. I was pin and needles. Jadi aku gugup atau tegang ataupun gelisah. Nah, katanya sepanjang hari ketika menunggu hasil ujian nasionalnya itu diumumkan. Ya. Jadi okay, itu namanya on pins on needles ya. Oke, okay, what about the number 9? Nah, number 9, this is very very popular in the native speakers ya. That is kicking one's heels. Kicking one heels. What's it? Just kick a heel or just nendang sepatu atau gimana? Nendang heel atau gimana? Nendang sendal atau gimana? No, it's not the meaning. Okay, the correct meaning is wasting one time while waiting for something, someone. It can be expressed that I kick one's heel, like you kick something, yeah, because you have wasted your time for writing something, yeah. Okay, contoh, for example, for instance, sitting on the bench of park, yeah. Johnny was kicking his heels while waiting for his friend to arrive. Atau, or we can change to another example. Sitting in front of the mall. Andy was kicking his heel while waiting for his friend to arrive, because Andy want to come along with his friend to get in the mall. Jadi, kicking oneself is wasting one time while waiting for someone or something. Yeah. Okay, lanjut kita ke number 10. Yeah. Might and main. Might and main. Okay, might and main. It's really cool. Yeah. Phrase yang sangat keren. Yeah. Okay. What about the meaning? Doing something by putting in all the effort. Jadi, doing something by putting in all the effort. Jadi kita melakukan sesuatu dengan sungguh-sungguh, dengan sekuat tenaga, maksudnya kayak gitu ya. Oke, okay. For instance, Leo was stuck in the building all night long. He shouted might and mine from the window, but no one come to his rescue. Jadi si Mike tadi dia terjebak di dalam bangunan ataupun kantor ataupun gedung itu sepanjang malam. Katanya he shouted might and mine from the window, but no one came to his rescue. Dia sudah berteriak sekuat tenaga, ya, might and mine dari jendela, tapi enggak ada yang datang buat menyelamatkannya. Nah, jadi might and mine itu doing something by putting in all the effort, ya. Jadi kita bisa menggunakannya dengan contoh-contoh yang lain, ya. Kalau kalian punya contoh yang lain, boleh di komen di bawah, ya. Buat latihan juga, ya, for your exercises. And then number 11 is kicking myself. Nah, kalau yang sebelumnya itu kicking one's heels, ini kicking myself. So there's so many phrases that we can build from the kicking. Yeah, kicking myself, meaning regretting something you should not have done. Nah, jadi regretting something you should not have done artinya menyesali sesuatu yang seharusnya kamu tidak lakukan. Bagaimana contohnya? Such as, I could just kick myself for not attending the party. Yeah, I could just kick myself for not attending the seminar. I could just kick myself for not attending the wedding of my friends. Yeah, jadi banyak. So kicking myself is regretting something you should not have done. Jadi menyesali sesuatu yang seharusnya tidak kita lakukan. Oke, lanjut ke nomor 12, itu ada namanya chalk and cheese. Ada chalk and cheese, ya, ada chalk and cheese. Nah, ada apa sih? Chalk and cheese, kapur sama keju. Oke. Artinya, the meaning is two people or things that are completely different from each other. Nah, jadi to express dua orang ataupun dua hal yang benar-benar sangat berbeda. Nah, satu sama lainnya, ya. Jadi chalk and cheese itu untuk mengekspresikan sesuatu atau seseorang, dua orang atau dua hal yang berbeda, ya, satu sama lain. Okay, just get to the example. For example, while Annie is an easygoing person, but her brother Leo is short-tempered. Both of them are like chalk and cheese. Okay, so chalk and cheese is described about easygoing person and the short-tempered. Yeah, both of the personality is so different, completely different, absolutely different. So we can use chalk and cheese to express two things. Yeah. Two persons or two personality or two characteristic that completely different each other. So that's chalk and cheese. Yeah. What about donkey? Number 13, ya. Yeah, 13. Number 13 itu ada donkey's ears. Ada donkey's ears. Maybe when you have read a lot of book about English book or novel, maybe you often find donkey's ears in some sentences, yeah, in the novel that you read. Okay, donkey's ears is the mean something which has been happening for quite a long time. Jadi for quite a long time. Nah, jadi donkey's ears itu untuk mengekspresikan sesuatu yang sudah terjadi atau sesuatu yang sedang terjadi dalam waktu yang cukup lama, ya. Contoh, for example, ya, Annie has been a vegan for donkey's years. Another example, Mr. Ahim, me, ya, has been a teacher for donkey's ears. Yeah, that's the use of the donkey's ear to express something that has been happening for quite a long time. Yeah, and then the last for this video, the last phrase for this video is kettle of fish. Kettle of fish. This is something new for me also, yeah, because very seldom to use this kettle fish even for my quote or my daily speaking, daily writing, and etc. Yeah, kettle fish. The meaning is a difficult or an awkward situation. Difficult or an awkward situation. Jadi ini untuk mengekspresikan sesuatu atau situasi yang sangat sulit. Ya, situasi yang sulit atau awkward, ya. Jadi awkward situation, kettle of fish itu ya. Contohnya, sitting on the first bench of the classroom is like a kettle of fish for some students. For example, you are a novice student in senior high school maybe, and then you got the first bench of the classroom. Maybe for some students, that's a really hard or difficult situation or awkward situation. So we can use the kettle of fish to express that situation. Yeah, sitting on the first bench of a classroom is like a kettle of fish for some students. Jadi kettle of fish itu untuk mengekspresikan sesuatu yang sangat sulit dalam situasinya ataupun agak aneh lah buat kita gitu, agak risih lah kita ya. Misalkan kita harus berhadapan langsung dengan guru misalnya, in front of the class, because you sit of the first bench of the classroom. Ya, okay. Nah, that's all for perasa-perasa keren yang ada di part 2 ini ya. Semoga bermanfaat buat kalian. Terus latih bahasa Inggris kalian dengan menggunakan hal-hal yang baru ya. Jangan pernah mau dengan cara yang monoton. Ya, okay. Thank you very much ya for your attention. Thank you very much for your watching my video ya. And keep waiting on my new video by visiting my channel Bapak Rahim ya. Thank you very much. Salam sukses. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.